Let's talk about unit vectors. So, quite simply, a unit vector is just any vector with a length or a magnitude of 1. So here on my graph, I've drawn several unit vectors, right? All these vectors you can see have a magnitude or length of 1. They're just pointing in different directions. Okay, so that's really simple. There's a bit more to unit vectors, though. So, first of all, there's two very special unit vectors that you'll see a lot. So let me show you on the graph what those special unit vectors are. All right, what I've just drawn in the picture here are what are called the coordinate unit vectors. So coordinate unit vectors. Okay, so they have special names. One of them is called I, and one of them is called J. So I is the vector 1, 0. So you can see in the picture, right, it has an x component of 1 and a y component of 0. And then the coordinate vector, the coordinate unit vector J, is the vector 0, 1. Okay, so it has an x component of 0 and a y component of 1. Okay, so why are these useful? Well, essentially, these give us another way, another helpful way to actually write vectors. So let me demonstrate. Okay, so here in the purple solid line, I've drawn a vector, and this is the position vector 3, 2, right? So it has an x component of 3 and a y component of 2. And then what I've done on the sides of the triangle here is I have kind of split this up into its x and y components. So the green dotted line along the x-axis, I can call that vector 3i, right? Because remember, I is a unit vector in the x direction with an x component of 1 and a y component of 0. So then 3i would just have an x component of 3, just purely in the x direction. So that's what I've drawn there in that green dotted line. Now 2j is my blue dotted line here, and you'll notice that points purely in the y direction, and it's 2 times the coordinate unit vector j. Okay? So what I can actually do is I can say that the vector 3, 2 equals 3i plus 2j. Okay, so once again, why is that true? Let me try to convince you component-wise. So here, remember, I just said that I was the position vector 1, 0, and j was the position vector 0, 1. So I'm proposing that I can write this 3i plus 2j. So component-wise, if I just substitute I in there, that's 3 times 1, 0 plus 2 times 0, 1, and if I work that out with scalar multiplication, that's a vector 3, 0 plus the vector 0, 2. Then if I add those by components, well, I get back my vector 3, 2. So this makes sense, right? With I and j as defined here, I can now write vectors, position vectors, in this new kind of ij notation. So that's what I and J, these coordinate unit vectors, do. They give us this other helpful way to write vectors. But there's something else that's important about unit vectors as well. So I've written it here. For any non-zero vector V, the vector U, which is defined as vector V divided by the magnitude of vector V, is a unit vector that points in the direction of vector v. Okay, so let's kind of unpack this and see why this is true. So first of all, what are we really doing here? So I have some vector u, and I'm saying that's defined as vector v divided by the magnitude of vector v. Well, another way I could write this, just algebraically splitting it up, is 1 over the magnitude of vector v times vector v, right? Now this here, 1 over the magnitude of vector v, is a number, right? Because the magnitude of v is a number, 1 over the magnitude of V is also a number. So what I'm essentially doing here is scalar multiplication. Right? I'm taking the vector V and multiplying it by the number 1 over the magnitude of vector V. Okay, so then what I just said is this is scalar multiplication. So remember, when we do scalar multiplication, we take our vector V and we multiply it by a scalar. So that either stretches it or compresses it, maybe flips it in the opposite direction, right? But it's still parallel to that original vector V. So that's why it makes sense that this new vector U is going to point in the direction of V, right? Because it's just a scalar multiple. Okay, so that explains that. But why is it a unit vector? Okay, so to think about that, let's think about what the magnitude of U is. Well, when we talked about scalar multiplication by components just a minute ago, we said that the magnitude, okay, so this is going to be the magnitude of 1 over that, okay, the magnitude of 1 over magnitude of V times V, which we said was 1, the absolute value of this constant out front, or this scalar, times the magnitude of vector V, okay? But look at this. I could rewrite this as the magnitude of vector V over the magnitude of vector V, so that's just 1. Okay, so that's what makes sense, is this is a unit vector. And furthermore, negative U, which is simply negative V over magnitude of V, is also a unit vector. That makes sense, right? This is just the same as vector U, but just pointing in the exact opposite direction. So then, what we can say, kind of as a summary, is that plus or minus V over magnitude of V are unit vectors parallel to the original vector V, that point in opposite directions. And if we take this just one step farther, so if plus or minus V over magnitude of V are unit vectors, right, parallel to vector V, so remember unit vector has length 1, if instead we want a vector of length C, plus or minus C, vector V over magnitude of V, are vectors of length C parallel to V, right? Because it's the same vector as this, just multiplied by a scalar of C.